to be here with you today. I was quite moved to watch your video, and I want to thank you all for the support and warm thoughts that have gone out to the family and myself during this year. Sorry. I would like to thank Commandant Griffith Evans and the KPTC for organizing this forum in memory of my husband and for inviting me to join you here in Accra as a representing the Kofi Annan Foundation. As a son of Ghana and Africa, the peace and security of the continent was a personal as well as a professional concern for my husband. Our distinguished speakers have already highlighted that the spread of violent extremism is destabilizing and terrorizing society and communities across Africa. Violent extremism is causing massive population displacement, economic disruption, and humanitarian crisis. We must recognize, however, that the drivers are multiple, complex, and context specific. With so many experts in the room, I will not pretend to know the answers to this existential threat. But however, allow me to flag 3 points in particular. First, evidence suggests that violent extremists cannot be solved through security responses and military solutions alone. It demands a holistic approach. According to the UN Development Programme's research on the sources of violent extremism here in Africa, socio-economic and political marginalization, a lack of education, state violence, and poverty are all contributing factors. This underscores the importance of closely aligning security and development strategies. Building democratic institutions and processes that ensures human rights and the rule of law and promote accountability are critical ingredients in countering extremism and should be an integral part of our peace efforts. Through its Elections and Democracy Program, the Kofi Annan Foundation works in a number of countries to strengthen the integrity of electoral processes in order to build, strengthen, and safeguard democracy, which also serves as a bulwark against extremism.